What happens if I lose my Microsoft Authenticator app? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. You know, there are several topics that I keep coming back to because the concepts come up so frequently. And as often as I talk about them, I keep hearing from people that just haven't gotten the message. I tend to go on about backing up, for example, or password managers, or two-factor authentication, that kind of stuff. Today's topic, account recovery information. A little bit of preparation that can save you a world of hurt in some situations. Situations like losing your Microsoft Authenticator app. So here's a picture of the Microsoft Authenticator app. This is actually on my phone. It's a picture of my phone. It kind of goes to show you that even though a screenshot is actually disabled on the Android device for this app, screenshot just turns up black. Clearly, if you can see it, you can copy it. And I've taken a picture of it to show you exactly what the application looks like. From Microsoft, Microsoft Authenticator is a free app that helps you sign in to all of your accounts without using a password, just a fingerprint, face recognition, or a PIN. Now, I want to be clear. The fingerprint, face recognition, or a PIN is not the Microsoft Authenticator app. Those are the security methods already offered by the mobile device. For example, in my case, on my phone, in order to use the authenticator, I have to provide my fingerprint or my PIN to the phone before the phone lets me actually run the app. So when you attempt to use the Microsoft Authenticator, you have to authenticate with your device using one of those techniques. So here's the scenario that I run into, and I want to be clear, this is going to sound a heck of a lot more complicated than it is, but I'm trying to be explicit about each step. I want to sign into a Microsoft service online. After I specify my email address, I'm told that I need to go open my Microsoft Authenticator app and respond to a prompt on that app. I'm also shown a two-digit number. So I pick up my phone, I open the Microsoft Authenticator, I'm asked, enter your screen lock to access Authenticator, along with, in my case, the fingerprint icon. I provide my fingerprint. The authenticator is then finally able to display, and what it displays is the authentication challenge. In this case, it's usually displaying three different two-digit numbers, and I'm supposed to tap on the number that was displayed on the website that I'm trying to sign into. I tap on that number, and I tap on allow, and then a few seconds later, the website I'm signing into updates, and I'm in. Now, the scenario that most folks are concerned about is the possibility of losing the device on which the authenticator is installed. If you don't have the authenticator, you don't have the ability to use it, of course. Fortunately, the system is absolutely designed to handle this situation, although it ends up being a little bit more inconvenient. When you take a look at the Check Your Authenticator message, you'll see two links. One says use your face, fingerprint, PIN, or security key instead. This switches to using Windows Hello authentication. In other words, you would authenticate on that computer. If you've configured Windows to authenticate using any of these items, you could use one of them instead. The other link is I don't have access to my authenticator app. This then takes you to an alternate authentication approach. The alternate authentication approach should seem super familiar. You'll be shown a partial email address or a phone number or both and asked to select one to receive a code. You'll select one option and you'll be asked to confirm that you actually know what it is. For example, if I were to select text, I would have to enter the full number that ends in 67 to prove that I know what that phone number is. Once I've done so, sends a code. Entering that code then signs me in. Now, once we're signed in, there are a couple of things we can do. We could do nothing, just assuming that you'll recover the device containing your Microsoft Authenticator. Maybe you lost it somewhere in the house. Or you can go through the steps to associate a new Microsoft Authenticator on a replacement device. But the bottom line is that you're in without having used the Microsoft Authenticator. You just had to jump through some other hoops that were perhaps, like I said, a little bit more time consuming than just tappy tap on your phone. Now, there is a scenario where the system can indeed fail. There's a huge assumption that's built into all this. And that assumption is this: you have previously configured email addresses or phone numbers on which to receive security codes, and you've kept them up to date. It sounds obvious, I get it, but believe me when I tell you that too many people fail this assumption. Either they never set this information up in the first place, or the information that they originally configured is now out of date. If you no longer have access to the configured email account or phone number, it's really no better than never having set it up in the first place. When this step fails, notice the "I don't have any of these" in the "we need to verify your identity" request, Microsoft will likely take you through a much more convoluted advanced account recovery sequence. This can be very frustrating. It can include delays of up to 30 days before regaining access to the account. And even worse, it can fail. If it fails, if you are unable to prove you are who you say you are, and you should be granted access to the account, you will not be granted access to the account. That account will be lost forever. Bottom line here is that I'm a huge fan of passwordless authentication and thus using things like the Microsoft Authenticator app if you can. However, it is critical that when you do that, you make sure to set up the alternate slash recovery information associated with the account. Use every opportunity to save this kind of information and then make absolutely certain that it's up to date, as things like perhaps your phone numbers or your email addresses change over time. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/178753. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.